Well, cetaceans matter because they are what's called apex predators, which means they're at the top of the food chain. So anything that's at the top of the food chain is going to have a huge impact all the way down. And another reason is that they are what's called ecosystem engineers. They have a massive impact on life in our oceans, and they've been around for tens of millions of years. So the health of our oceans really depends on the health of cetaceans. There's been a lot in the press about the impact of Navy sonar and other types of loud sound production on dolphins and whales. And it is a real concern. There is a lot of noise in the ocean. They call it noise pollution. And that includes also shipping traffic and other things that we don't have a lot of control over. So one of the things that the Navy has been doing is they have observers, marine mammal observers, who are on their vessels and will scan the horizon, looking several kilometers. I mean, they've got binoculars and everything. They're looking as far as they possibly can to make sure there are no cetaceans within a certain radius when they do the sound testing. So that's one thing. Another thing that they're doing is they're listening and having underwater microphones, which are called hydrophones, in the ocean, and those pick up the calls of whales and dolphins. And if they hear something, then they know, well, there's something in the area we can't test. And in fact, for some of the really endangered species, like the right whales, the North Atlantic right whales, there's only a few hundred left. And they do have some songs that they produce. And if they pick up that there are some right whales in the area, then they alert all the vessels so that they can avoid ship strikes, which is a big problem for the right whales. In my own background, I started out very interested in animal behavior, but I was focused on primates, and I was interested, like many, in East African wildlife. And I incidentally switched to dolphins, and very little was known about dolphins when I started 30 years ago. We've had many surprises since then. And I would say one of the biggest surprises is how individually variable every single dolphin is. So once you've known them for so many years and seen them year after year, like each one is distinct. It's distinct in how they hunt, it's distinct in how they socialize, they're distinct in how they care for their offspring. So when people say, what's a dolphin like? I want to say, which one? Like if somebody asked you, what are humans like? I'd say, well, I can tell you about a couple of people I know, but how would I tell you about what humans are like? And it's like that with dolphins.